Mulungu wanga lero ni kuyambika na mutima wanga ne. Wanipasa nzeru, wanipasa chuma na warakata ne. Bakazi baka niona wanikonda wa makungwira neo. Umafuta na mutima ne.
My name is Peter Senzagaze. I'm a Zambian musician, an Afro dance musician, Afro dance, Afro pop, Afro soul. Anything that is good music is what I make, and I sing about politics, I sing about religion, I sing about social life, and I sing about anything that a lot of people go through. It could be problems, it could be happiness. I make happy music, I make sorrow music, and I make any music. So I'm just a musician for everybody. And this right here is about my forthcoming album, King Solomon, and coming out on the 26th of August 2015, which is a Wednesday. So it's gonna be out and on the shelf, selling in the leading supermarkets, and of course some other places that are going to be communicated to the people to get that CD, and also on iTunes. So it's called King Solomon and it's out. I named my album King Solomon because over the time through my albums and my music, a lot of people have complained to say I don't do love songs, I don't do a lot of songs about women. So I thought and believed I should do this album to have everything to do with women, but I cannot pick on one topic. I'm not very good at doing love songs, so I cannot do an album about women and love, or a lot of other issues that a lot of other artists are talking about. So I thought, let me do an album that has got every topic to do with women, but talk about the topics that a lot of people don't talk with, deal with. So I'm talking about King Solomon's wisdom, and because the album and each and every song on the album has got something to do with women, I thought I should call it King Solomon, because you know King Solomon is associated with wisdom and a lot of women. So a lot of women topics on the album, a lot of wisdom, and just wanting to have the right judgment. That's why I called it King Solomon. What I want to gain out of this, first and foremost, I do everything for the industry. They say it's not always good to blow your own horn, or maybe to praise yourself, but I've reached a level where I just want to believe, and I've convinced myself I'm quite a trendsetter, and a lot of things that I do, I have a lot of other artists, young ones and established, that are looking up to me and trying to go that direction. So the biggest thing that I want to gain out of this is not just probably a personal gain, is to, I want to see other artists, myself and other artists, gain courage and belief that they can sell. So the reason why I'm releasing this album is just to make people believe, and other artists believe, that you can do an album and sell the music. Because a lot of artists right now, the new ones, the established ones, the old ones that I found in the game, are associating themselves with single, where you do. Of course, this is where the kind of life that a lot of artists worldwide are doing. You drop a single and then it comes out, and then you promote and you do shows. But I want people to believe that as much as you can do single, you can still do albums. That's why we see all these Western artists doing these albums, putting them on iTunes, Amazon, and all those online shops and stores. So I just want every Zambian out there, despite of what challenges we are facing right now, to just believe we should do albums and launch it, and launch them, and let their own people buy that CD, play it in their cars, at home, at their kitchen parties, and any party that they are having. So it's about sales and bringing back the vibe of selling in the music industry. That's why I'm doing it. The challenges that we face as musicians in the music industry right now in Zambia is, one, every artist or musician in Zambia is self-made. There's no structure on a government level or any organization that is running the structure or the business of the artist. We are what we are, I am what I am, and every artist out there, they are what they are because of what they've done. They do it on their own. And there is also issue of papyrus, which is eating us a lot too much, that it's very hard to make sales and a lot of people are shunning away because the streets are infested with papyrus, in a sense that I know and we all believe, we all know that papyrus cannot be killed or finished overnight or just be phased out as it is. But there, you can probably try to minimize the way people do papyrus or pirate music, because right now people are selling music openly, like it's not a crime to have a counterfeit CD or to sell pirated music or infringing on any person's rights by reproducing their works. In Zambia, people, the biggest thing is that you see that these people don't know it is a wrong thing to sell pirated music. They think music, I don't know, whatever reason, they just think it's okay, you use your common sense, make some CDs and make a collection, people will buy. There is no proper enforcement on trying to clean the streets out of piracy, really. So that's the second challenge that I'll talk about. This other one is exploitation due to no backup. The industry has got a problem with ratings. You cannot really rate how much you want to be paid. The young artists that are coming in will be the most happening today, but it does not know anything to do with that charging and how you can charge, or they just come and get every little money they can get. But if there was a standard and there was a regulation board, we're going to be having people just do a song and quite become comfortable and very wealthy out of the song. Music has made a lot of people rich worldwide. Some clips of 10 minutes, of 1 minute, 3 minutes have made people wealthy and rich worldwide, I would say. But in here, so I'm talking about piracy, I'm talking about a political government will, and I'm talking about exploitation as well from the corporate entities, from the so-called promoters or club owners or any people that have got a little bit of money to put and show, the people that are show interest into the industry. The industry locally is doing very well, because you can go to a Zambian function and listen to Zambian music from A to Z, and you can tell that the music, the industry locally is doing well from how almost every person wants to use music to sell their product, or how everyone wants to look successful by incorporating music to their business or to their functions. And lately we've seen a lot of politicians associating music to their campaigns and having all these musicians to come along, because they know the influence and they know what musicians are able to do. So I think music, Zambian music locally, is doing very well. Internationally as well, it is doing well, especially that one very big example I can give is Congo DR, which is a former Zaire. Back in the days, Congo was the only one that had colonized us, Zambia, musically colonization, that every person was listening to rumba music. But today, rumba is not as playing as much as it was playing back in the days. And we are, Zambian music, are playing in Congo much as they are playing in our country right now. You, from Lubumbashi to all these neighboring towns in Congo, they are playing our music. Namibia, Botswana, and Malawi, Zimbabwe, all our neighboring countries are feeling the music, and we are doing quite well right there. It's like our music is playing more out there than these other neighboring countries' music is playing in our country. Apart from South Africa and Nigeria, that are quite playing because of non-TV channels, and our music is doing it without all that, just by hard work. I personally, I can confess of winning 6 awards for a song I wrote in Namibia for a young lady. We've toured the UK, we've toured the US, we've toured Africa. So I believe music is doing well internationally and locally. Talking about gaining what we want to gain, or what one wants to gain in the music industry, is really based on what a person really, as an artist, wants to gain out of the industry? Is it just fame? Are you in the music industry so you can make a few coins to feed your family or be able to take yourself to school or a lot of other reasons? But like I said, there's all these hindrances and everything like that. So it is, you aim high and you work so hard, you put in too much effort, but you can just reap limited stuff. It's not as you can only reap enough, less than what you really aspiring for, what you want to gain out of it. So it is a hustle, and we need the corporate world out there as an industry. We need the business firms and the business world. We need the government to come in. We've done what we can do as musicians, really, for us to reach this level where we make this good music that each and every person know. Some of us are household names, and then it's all within our powers and what we've done. Prayer, hard work, and overworking. We need a hand out there. We need all these people with money. It's a business, so it can generate funds. It's able to bring people like us to this level where we are with only what we are standing, starting from wherever. A lot of people started from one room house, or from sleeping in a kitchen at the neighbor's house, to owning a house in Chalala. Then I believe it is something that is able to bring you money, as long as it's treated as a big business, because music is big business. Music and national development, or economically, or just, I believe a lot of other countries, we can talk of Sweden, we can talk about art musicians like ABBA, we can talk of Jamaica as in the world's largest music producing country, have made a lot of money out of music. And I believe there's a lot of loopholes and a lot of things that are left hanging that can probably make the government make money. I can tell you a lot of things that music, how vast music can bring money into the country. There's, everyone wants to be entertained. Everyone wants a light time some day. And there is music from sales, a CD sales, what I'm talking about, like King Solomon. There's also music, there's also ringtones, there's also caller tones. Every time you're calling someone, there's this press what to get this song, press star, get this song at this much. It's money as well. And there are downloads. A lot of people fee you downloading music is free music. If structures are put properly, you know that free download that you think is a free download is not really free, because you bought talk time that you converted into bundles. Bundles that are going to be directed to download a certain link online. So I think we can follow accounts like that and get your money from the downloads that were converted into talk time that is converted into money. So you can get your money from how much bundles are used to download your music, with working with improved and well-established entities. So right after all that being said, and I believe right now every artist out there should go out there, work on an album, and let's try to add value to this industry. And I want to beg every Zambian and every Zambian music lover out there, whether in Zambia or outside Zambia.
This is Tony Rollercoaster from Hot 87.7. My man Peterson is prolific, I can call him that way. You know, his music has really inspired me. I was forced to actually jump on one of his songs we did, Kapidi Pidi, back in the days. For me, I think Peterson is a package that you can't unwrap. You know, he's not an ordinary musician who's going to talk about something that you know. If you listen to a Peterson song, it'll take you probably 2-3 days to figure out what he was talking about, and then you'll be surprised that the stuff he was talking about is actually good stuff and very positive stuff. He's a straight to the point kind of a guy. When he feels something, he's going to talk about it through his music. And for me, I would urge you out there to keep supporting Zeme Music, quality Zeme Music like Peterson's music. So look out for his new CD. I know it's going to be the bomb. So remember to support Zambian music by buying original Zambian music, and I mean quality Zambian music, like Peterson's new CD is called King Solomon. Get it now.
Hi, my name is Jonathan Nyerenda, from Trying to Beat Pilato. I'm an artist, I'm a rapper, and my name is, my stage name is T.L.P. Peterson is not just an artist, he's beyond an artist, he's on another level. I've been listening to his music for a very, very long time. He's my play dad, I call him father, he calls me Sunny, so I know what I'm talking about. His new project, King Solomon, is untouchable. You need to grab a copy, sit down, listen to the songs, get the message of the songs. He's trying to communicate with the youths in a certain way. And that's very, very important. So check this out.
Hi, my name is Flavor from Hot 87.7, number one for news and entertainment. I've known Peterson for 10 years now. I think that I started working with him on his first album, up to now, Become Friends, and I think that his music has grown from where it was then. Buy Zambian music, because Zambian music is employing Zambians. Look out for his forthcoming album, King Solomon. Blah! Wani pasa nzeru, wani pasa chuma na warakatane Wakazi waka niona, wani konda wa makungwira neo Umafuta na mutima neo Sinifuna vizimu za King Solomon.